Hey Brickheads, Scott with 36 Bricks here, taking a quick look at two, not one, but two food trucks. Let's check it out. All right, guys, super excited about having these a part of my city. As you guys know, I have done reviews on the other food trucks, and I'm really excited. I could have easily done one review per video, but just figured because they were both food trucks, I just threw them in there together. So first and foremost, we are doing the Lego Icons retro food truck. Now, to be honest, it says retro food truck, but it's really a hot dog truck, just being honest, because that's pretty much what they're selling, hot dogs and shakes. So it's not just a full food truck, but this is set number 40681. Super excited about this set. I mean, great minifigures. If you take a look down here at these minifigures, great torso details. I'm always very, let's just say disappointed in the legs because there's not much there. I know a lot of pants, don't have a whole lot, but they could add pockets. They could add some kind of work. But nevertheless, great detail work on the torsos. We got a little belt action. We got a little necklace and all that kind of fun stuff. So really excited to have that as part of my city. Great hair color, great minifigure altogether. And then we have the food truck operator, which of course has the stripes on the sweater. Is carrying a hot dog. Face is pretty neutral, so nothing too excited there. But all in all, great minifigures. Simple, sweet, to the point. Now, when it comes to this little mini build sign, I love how they did the technique on it. Really works well. The sticker work is amazing. I love the details on the graphics and all of that stuff on both sides. Here you see hot dog fries and a shake. So that's pretty cool. Coming over to the truck, you have a back end here where you have, your condiments, your mustard, your ketchup, all that kind of fun stuff. Here we have the hot dog window. Now this pivots up and down. I really actually like how they did the work on this. It looks really nice. And then the truck itself. Now you pop the lid off or the top and you come right down here and you get that full view of all the details inside. Really like what they did here. They made you a couple shakes. Really great part work when it comes to the gold claws, like the Wolverine claws. They made those into French fries. So really happy about that. And then you have a nice little grill going on there and a faucet. So really like the details on this. It really makes for a good set and a good, story that you can put in your city. So that's review number one, guys. So moving on to review number two, this is the hamburger truck, set number 60404, 194 pieces. Now this one over here had 310, so a lot more part intensive, and then it had two minifigures. This one here, 194 pieces, two minifigures. So really cool with that. Taking a look at the minifigures at first, really love the detail work in, the outfit on this one. You have a nice little record, very cool printing. Again, disappointed in the legs, but I get it. And then I love how, if you take a look to the side, they have a hearing aid, which is really cool. Really love that they're adding, diversity into the city and you're adding those details and all of that kind of fun stuff. And then you have the Burger Girl or the waitress, I guess, the cook, whatever you want to call them, doesn't really have a title on the box for the name of the minifigure, but really like the torso work, really great logo on her overalls. Or is it a apron? Let me know in the comments below. Not exactly sure. It could be either or. Could be an apron or overalls, just with a print. Moving on to the small build here. That is not so small. It is a giant burger. I don't know. I feel like there could have been an easy way to make a smaller burger than this. It totally makes sense, but at the same time, this thing is the size of their legs. So proportion-wise, it's not really the best, but it still looks cool. You do get a nice little fork, which I'm always down for nice utensils. So we're going to back up the minifigures here and take a look at the truck. Now, great sticker work and design work on the design or emblem, logo, whatever you want to call it. Great work on the overall part usage and piece usage. You can totally tell that this is a burger, and it does come with a flatbed truck, which is nice. The cool part about this is actually the burger comes off and actually can work as just a standalone building or a stand, and then you can have this truck as a flatbed truck through your city if you wanted. So all in all, like if you decided to buy a couple of these, you could have a flatbed truck rolling around your city, and then you could also have, a burger truck rolling around your city. Now, when it comes to the truck itself, there's not a whole lot to it. Great print work on the sides, really love that. Always down for prints. The front of the truck is simple and sweet. I really like the way they did that. And then coming around to the back, there's really not much to it other than to do it. And you have that. It would have really been cool if this was a like a tilt up. That way, if they were dropping this stand off at some point, that this would just roll off. But that's wishful thinking, I guess. As far as the size of the truck, it is a one-person truck. You could easily move the wheel over and try to fit two people in, because it is six studs wide. You might be able to fit two people in. It might be tight. Just depends on how you place their hands, to be honest. But all in all, really great truck. Moving on to the burger stand itself. Again, really great details. I really love how they did it. You have a nice little side door here where you can open up, if I can get it, and you can kind of see inside. But then also the top pops off, and you have free range to look inside. Now, as far as the details inside, there's really not much to it. I mean, what do you expect for 194 pieces? But you have a burger patty, you have what would kind of be, I guess, on the stove or the grill, and then you have the front window with a ketchup bottle. They could have added a mustard bottle. I mean, it's 194 pieces. Buck up, give us six more pieces. You got, a couple more pieces for the grill work. You get a couple more pieces for a mustard bottle, and you're solid. So, that's just kind of, again, a nitpick. I mean, the top of the bun, really cool on how they did that. They rounded it off, and then they put sesame seeds on it, which is awesome. So, really like what they did here. Really like what they did here. All right, guys. So there you have it. Two reviews in one. A couple great food trucks that are rocking out, the burgers and the hot dogs. Now we need, more juice trucks or more, burrito, maybe a taco truck or something like that. That would be cool. We've had a pizza truck in the past, but really love the fact that they're, popping in these food trucks and stuff like that. It really adds to the city, and I'm super excited about it. So there you have it, guys. Thanks for watching. I really do appreciate all the love and support, and we will see you next time on 36 Bricks.